Hello guys, welcome to episode number 12 now, I believe, of Urban Design of City Skylines with me, Praised. Now, last episode, we didn't do much work in terms of actual progression. It was more of a bit of a recap sort of an episode with a bit of development here and there, just general ideas flowing. I did actually get quite a few very good ideas that I actually do want to think about actually implementing. And one of those ideas is actually to make my downtown park a little bit bigger and to try and emphasize, see if I can actually make it sunken a little bit. And so that way we can have like paths crossing over the top of it, have a nice little park underneath, natural pathways as well. So I think we'll focus on doing a little bit of work on that, as well as also doing a little bit of modifications to some of our streets as well within the downtown, or should I say avenues actually. This is an idea from Daladuck, and it's to actually create roads underneath the elevated railway lines within the downtown area so that I can get better utilization of that empty space underneath the railway lines. So that's something we're going to be experimenting with this episode. So without any further ado, I'll get straight into it then, eh? So there we go. Let's just jump into our downtown. All right, so first things first, we're going to be demolishing quite a few things, such as these car parks from underneath, because we're going to need this space. I'm going to pause the game. I'm going to remove some of these roads as well from here. We might have to create a new entry point with this bridge. Okay, so that's all good and done, I believe so anyway. We're still going to have to make a few modifications, but we'll see what we do. Okay, so we're going to jump into the collide tool. We're going to jump down to ground level, and we are going to create a new avenue, which goes parallel or perfectly underneath the actual railway lines. So the next connection that I believe that I have to do will be out to, say, out to here. Let's just make it out to there. Can I actually now? No, I cannot. So let's see if we can actually push this out by 2 units, which we can. So we can make a temporary connection. Something like that, so that we can get a bit of a guide of what we are actually doing or where we are actually going with this. Now, the railway lines will actually run over the top, but before we do, yes, if we just check our actual avenue, we do have connections, so this is good to see. Now we're going to jump into our railway lines. I'm going to extend the railway lines out to here for now. And now we need to jump into the overlap mode, and as you can see, we can place them over the top. Yes, we can. And now we just got to place them in a way so that they can just be over the top, not interfering with any of the actual roads itself themselves, like so. Okay. And this way we can utilize this space quite a lot better. Like so. Like so, and now, can we just connect that up? I think we can. Perfect. All right. I really like that. Now, the overlap actually does create some issues on some of the avenues surrounding it, so let's just try and fix that up. So what I mean by issues is it creates extra zonable boxes underneath here, which will mean pretty much they can zone on top of the road, and I don't want that. So one way that I've found that I can do that is change the avenue surrounding or connecting roads with them, and you should be able to clear out any inconsistencies with overlapping. There you go, you see any overlapping zonable spaces on roads that you may not necessarily want them to be on. Okay, so now let's just upgrade this back up to what it was. And that just gives us some better utilization and extra space to add extra residential, or not even residential, just any sort of what's the word I'm looking for? Any type of zoning. That's the word that I'm looking for. Okay, so although it doesn't do it kind of keeps moving along, which is something that I'm not particularly happy with to see. Okay. So we're just gonna have to keep playing around with this, I assume. So upgrade that. We're in overlap mode, silly me. Okay, so upgrade that, that, and all this should be now fixed. There we go. How silly was I then? Didn't realize that. That's the dangerous thing when you're using overlap mode and all that kind of jazz, is that it can cause you to veer which mode you're in. Okay, so it's cleared up the roads rather nicely. Except for over here, we still need to fix that up. Okay, and I think we'll be able to push this avenue out even by one more. Oh, no, we'll leave it as it is. It's fine. But what we're going to have to do is find a new way to connect. So let's see what we can do. Over here, I'd like to perhaps add some side streets in between some of these avenues. And with these side streets, what I'm trying to do is avoid traffic lights as well, because the more traffic lights we have in this sort of an area, and it's only a side street essentially, the more congestion we're going to get inside the city. So we're going to try and avoid that sort of thing. So we're going to turn the traffic lights off with the traffic manager. And that's pretty good. I must say I'm very pleased with that kind of result. Okay, so now this avenue is obviously going to stay here. But what we might do is actually continue, if we can find what we need, is this avenue tool, and connect that avenue to continue across. And we might have to get a bit creative over here to see what we can potentially do and how we can actually connect things up. Okay, so now let's get rid of this. Let's continue this out to here. Let's remove these train lines from over here. There we go. And over here, this is going to have to be moved out a little bit. And we can remove that, remove that. Okay. So from around here, let's see what we can do. Something like that. Now we can create our avenue, which will flow directly to where? Here, cut across and out to here. So this allows us to remove this, these lots. Let's dezone them. And remove this, remove this avenue from here. This is no longer required. Okay, and I'm thinking, yes, that's what I'm thinking. Just the wrong avenue. There we go. Let's jump into our train tracks. The first part can be collide. So we'll collide it straight to there. And now we'll jump into overlap and just try and make these connections as simple and as straight as possible without actually making posts show up on intersections. Okay, I think that will work right about there. Can make the next one as well. Out to there. Alright, so we got a couple of intersections showing up over here, so this will have to change. Out to there, this out to here. Now, this is not initially my idea, guys. This is actually from a very serious viewer that's really enjoying my series that came up with this idea, and I have to completely agree with him that this is a fantastic idea. I'm really liking it. So it reminds me of kind of like the Chicago network inside the city. I think it is Chicago, where they've got the elevated rails running over the streets and avenues. So that's a nice little touch. So anyone from Chicago that's watching, adds a little element of Chicago into our beautiful city of Verrocchio. Okay, so now we need to jump into Collide for all the surrounding streets so that we can kind of fix the little overlaps that are happening around over here. And that should be all of them. Okay, now we'll just upgrade the avenues back to the tree-covered avenues. Let's see from here out to there. This out to here. Yeah, that was right. Okay, there we go. And over here we can think of doing something. We'll see. All right. Now, next segment I was thinking is expanding this park out a little bit. So I'm just going to remove... No, that's not what I wanted to remove. I wanted to continue this through to here. And then go out in this direction. This direction, remove that. Join that up. Connect that. And now remove these two. What do we have? 10 by 9. So we're going to have to remove this. Go about by 9 units. And now we should have 10 by 10, which we do. Okay, perfect. So they'll give us perfect connections. Exactly what I want to see. Let's remove these two. Let's go out by 2 units. Go out over here like so. Now, can we actually connect this up perfectly? We can, but kind of. Not necessarily. So say, let's, for example, have a look. If we were to make this street straight, we can actually make this work. Let's remove this. Let's connect this avenue up. There you go, right over, maybe not. Yes, we can. We will be able to. So make that straight as well. So there you go. You got perfect zoning, 4x4. And we just might be able to make a this connect the way we want it. It's a little bit skewed and a little bit off here. What can we do to help this? What if we were to remove these intersections? There's nothing that we can really do to help this out, can we? If we make it... No, it always wants to clip up a little bit. So what if we connect it to the piece that's down here? Yeah, it always wants to clip up a bit. So let's just try and get this as close as possible and then just join that last little bit. And it creates too much. I'm not enjoying that. So out to here. And that creates only three blocks. Three zonable blocks that are kind of skewed away. So I can perfectly find that acceptable. I'm just going to remove that. And let's see now, if we build this road like that, now that creates this road to be completely skewed. So now that we're finding out these little things, what I'm thinking is that it will be more beneficial to us, and that creates a little awkward space over here. Into awkward spaces though, we can potentially build tall buildings. So okay, that's not the end of the world. If I zone that out there, okay, that's fine. I'm happy with that. We can zone this up. No problems, I don't think. We'll find a way. Actually, speaking of zoning, we can just extend this through. Here we go. How about that? This is falling into place nicely. This can join up to here. What do we have over here now? This out to here. So we need to go out by 9 units. And now that should be 7 by 7. And join up. Perfect. All right. Yes, we do have a couple of gaps over here, but I think we can live with those gaps. They're not the end of the world. I don't think there's any other solution in order to utilize this space any better. Let's see if we can now do something about this area. Now, no, that's not going to happen over here. So what we might do is have to start this bend a little bit sooner in order to make this flow better. So if I were to draw that out to here, and this is what it's all about. It's just constant reconfiguring, rejigging until you find a desired result. There you go. So we've got a little bit of an empty space right here in the middle, but we'll be able to fill that out with something. I'm sure we will be able to do something about that. But at least now this building around over here is now pretty much well covered. We can potentially put another tall building somewhere around over here. So yeah, not too shabby at all, not too bad. Now having a look at this building though, we've got a little bit of a gap over here. Perhaps we can make like a footpath that covers this little strip. We do have a footpath over here, so maybe some paths like this may help. Okay, so the lights are on the building side. I'd prefer to keep the lights on the opposite side of the building, so like that, and that works for me. And then perhaps what side does this create lights on? Same side, opposite side of the building. Okay, perfect. So we've got some extra features such as walkways or walk paths set up over here, so I'm liking that. Okay, so now with this park, perhaps we don't need to continue this across because this is going to be part of the park. Oh well, we'll see if it's going to be part of the park. Because I'm also trying to break up a bit of the boxiness, the rectangles and the squares within the actual city. I'm trying to make it look as if it's been kind of developed a little bit more naturally. So let's see. I think this will have to come out by 3 units. That way we've got enough space to build some connecting parks. Okay, so now let's remove this and let's re-input some streets over here. Let's make it go out by 3. And let's see if we can actually just connect an avenue up. These two kind of avenues up together. So if I push that up to there, what's that? 11 by 16. Okay, so what we might have to do is stretch that out by an extra click, I reckon. So that's 11, 12. And what's that going to give us? 10 by 16. So this will go out by... Oh, what's it give us? 10 by 16. So we'll go out by 6. And that should now give us that. And no, we won't be able to join that up. Because it's too close to an intersection, unfortunately. So this will not be perfect in terms of spacing, but, or in terms of length, it will be 10 by 11, but that's close enough. It's going to be a park only. So there we go. What we can do is move this park out to here. There we go. Now we can remove that, and all this will be park area. And perhaps we can like sink, do a little bit of sunken park around here, over here, with maybe a small little lake, tiny little lake with a footpath surrounding it. That's in the future, so we'll leave that for now. Okay, so we've got our buildings over here connected to this avenue. Sorry, yes, to these. Actually, yeah, we do have this avenue here. We've got two avenues next to each other. This is kind of pointless, so we can kind of remove some of this. We can actually do a few modifications around over here now, because we might, yes, this will need to continue across but not stop over there. This will have to probably connect at a different point over here now. So let's see, this can now continue out in this direction, and right now over here we're gonna have to remove this. We can keep the zoning, we can remove this, and we can remove that. I know we have to remove these car lots now, because we're going to have to place this shopping center somewhere else. Now, what would provide us with a decent space or zone? I don't think anything around over here will provide us what we need. So, actually, let's see. Will this zone right here next to this provide us with enough space? No, that won't. However, if we built it... Actually, we might be able to get this done. Let's see. We remove that. Let's put that complex back in. Let's move you. Ah, no, there is the avenue in the way. And even if we go into overlap, yes, even in overlap, there is one small section that kind of just overlaps a little bit too much. So how far are you actually overlapping? By one piece, I think. One little segment. Okay, so we won't do that. We will have to, however, remove this for the time being. So we'll de-zone this because we're going to have to figure out what to place in here. Perhaps we can just continue this street to cut across our through here. And I think that's the easiest and best logic around over here right now. So we'll do a normal street with parking for the time being. There we go. And because we've removed quite a lot of office spaces, we're going to try and replace some of these office spaces. So there we go. Now, we'll see what happens. Next to this shopping complex, I think it'd be nice to replace one of those car parks which we removed from our downtown area. So let's just place one right over here. Gonna zone up a few more office spacing, a little bit more office spacing around the area, like so. And we'll see how this develops. Now, while we wait or see this, our demand for industry go down a little bit, perhaps we can add just a tiny bit more office space around over here like that. And you know what? Let's remove that and let's cover this zone up as well. Let's just cover it up. There we go. Now, over here, you may not really see it. It's not very clear, but these are two blocks of four. It's not actually a 4x4. It's slightly skewed and off. So you won't get a 4x4 building growing here. So I've got a better way of utilizing this space, and that's by adding a sunken plaza. Oh, maybe not. Maybe we don't have that availability. Well, that's going to be quite bad if we can't do that. Just pause the game for a second, can we? No, we can't. It's being really, really difficult. I don't like it when it's being difficult. Okay, so let's zone that out like that. Now, what's being changed? There's a couple of segments, but that's okay. They're all 4x4s or something like that. So what does this give us? 5x5. So we can now simply connect that up like that. Okay. So we're going to be utilizing this space a little bit better now. Okay, so as night approaches, we're going to let these areas develop a little bit. We've got everything connected that we like. Further later on in the series, in the next couple of episodes, as we continue working on our downtown area, we'll keep developing these streets and avenues, and we'll find ways of being able to connect everything up. Now, one thing before we continue, we also have to connect this bridge up now. So this is one thing that I have forgotten. So this bridge... Let's see. So if we were to, for example, find a way to try and, find a way how we can connect this up. So if we were to continue from here, let's see, 9x2, so 7 units. And then just join up like that. That's the best kind of connection I can get, possibly get over here, I reckon. Possibly. Now, next thing is where to get this ramp, this avenue ramp, to connect into our downtown area now. This is the next complicated situation. I think initially what Dulla Duck wanted me was to put the actual railway lines over the top of the avenue. That way I'd avoid this problem where I don't know where to join up the avenue. But I'd much prefer the look of the actual bridge when you've got the railway lines underneath the road. So that's why I went with this method of constructing the road over the top of the railway lines. So this leaves me with a few considerations now. Okay, so one consideration is I could potentially remove some of these areas like this. Continue that avenue. I'm very satisfied with that avenue. This avenue, on the other hand, may be a little bit overkill for now. So let's just remove that. So I've got an idea that's kind of not brewing, but in my mind, that avenue could have actually been quite useful. But we'll see what happens. We'll remove that avenue. And we'll join this up to here. Let's go out by 12 units by 12. Okay, so that will create that sort of a height. Now, my next thing is, we've got an awkward number here. We do have a very awkward number here. I might actually have to push this across in terms of what I'm trying to do. Just give me a second. I'm trying to figure things out over here, guys. So this is part of the whole process that I go through normally off camera, but I guess you guys can see a bit of the thinking process now on camera. All right, so I just have to figure out where things are actually going and connecting to. So if we connect this straight to here, this straight out to here, what I have in mind is to actually skip across the actual avenue over the top of one another. So 12 by height. We'll jump into overlap. And will this actually work? How wide is the pillar? That actual pillar is not that great. It actually kind of, jumps over the actual road itself. So let's try side pillars. And that's no good either. Ooh, so we won't be able to do a road over the top of another road unless we download a mod. But I don't want to download that mod because it's going to start getting really, really crazy. Although crazy is what we're after, isn't it? Well, not necessarily, but being able to select the specific pillars as well. Because then this would go over the top. We'd still be able to zone without actually losing zoning space. This could come up straight and forward and join up over here to this bridge. So I think that is exactly what I want to do. But in order to do that, we need to download a mod. So I'm going to just pause the game for a second and we're going to transition. And when we come back after this transition, we'll have the mod. So let's do this. All right, guys. So I've gone ahead and downloaded the mod. And here we go. When we press the roads, we get this option up over here. It's called Elevated Network Pillars, and it requires a few extra mods, not just on its own. So I think the No Pillars mod is required, and it's compatible with other mods as well, like Traffic Plus Plus and network extensions and so on. You can go into the details yourselves. Just type in elevated network pillars. I just went into Steam and typed in pillars, and it was pretty much the first result that showed up. So it gives you the type of bridge pillars that you want, I assume. So I really haven't had much of a look. So, but yeah, you can see that there's quite a few options, but not too familiar with it yet, but all I've come up with is that all I need is a super stack for exactly what it is that I want. So we're gonna try and super stack it. Now, obviously, while we're super stacking this, we have to also go into the overlap mode, otherwise we won't be able to place this over the top of, well, wherever we need to place it, which is this avenue. So there we go. So we've just super stacked that over the top, and that looks pretty good to me. And so from this point on, though, however, we're going to jump into collide, and we're not going to jump into super stack. We're just going to jump into none, and let's see what we can do here. If we were to cut this down to 12, and perhaps over here from this certain point we can create, like, I don't know, an avenue or something that connects up. I'm not yet sure, we'll find out. So perhaps behind this railway station we will have to change a few buildings or something like that. So yeah, we'll see. Perhaps what we can do is continue a super stacked route going throughout this area perhaps, and what we can do is even connect this highway to the super stacked road, and that's actually a pretty good idea. We might do that actually. So let's just jump into pillars and collide. We'll continue our normal avenue across, so we might not get very good utilization around some areas around over here. So let's just remove that. We're gonna have to remove a bit of this, I apologize guys. There we go, and let's push this through like so. There we go. So this is kind of the work that I do. I've already mentioned it just like literally just like right now, but this is the kind of work I normally do off camera that you guys don't see, but I guess I can show you guys once in a while as well. It may not be everyone's kind of forte, but I hope you guys are enjoying what you are seeing. Alright, so we're going to jump back into the super stack mode, and we need to go into overlap, of course, as well. So if I overlap this out to, say, right there, so it's kind of even with the other side, yes. And then just jump this across by one unit, if we can. Yep. And then jump that out to, say, somewhere around over here. Let's see. Now, this is the little thing, difficult things, when you're actually creating things that you shouldn't be creating. I hope something like this does actually get added to the game. So now, as you can see, what we have is, no, the pillars are actually held on the outside and not on the inside of these avenues. So now they're actually not interfering with any of the roads that are currently running underneath. So that's a good thing. So the next thing that we need to focus on is seeing how we can connect this all up relatively nicely. So let's see. This will obviously have to start going up. So let's just start pushing it by one unit out to here. And from here, we'll go into just our normal collide, and we won't be using the super stack, we'll just be using a normal. And let's see, if I were to say, for example, no, that won't work. So from here, can we join up? Let's see, if we join it up to here, we're gonna have to jump out to here and then join up. No, that's not gonna work. Okay, so that's good to know at least. So let's see, how tall is this? This is 39 units high, so we might push this up to go up to say at least like, this is why we wanted a bend, isn't it? So 30 units, 33. Actually, let's just make it 30. So what did we go up from? So if we go up by 2, so 15 to 30, that's 50. So we've gone up double the height, so that's fine. That's quite believable, I think. And why are we, bridge pillar. Oh, so this actually controls the actual pillars as well. So, okay, so what we need to do is remove this. And now that we need bridge pillar, we need the medium bridge, highway, no. Large road bridge suspension, no. Railway, no. Pedestrian elevated pillar, highway, default, I guess, then. And yes, this will be right. Okay, so 30. I'm just trying to see where we can, how far do we have to go to actually get another pillar to show up. Right there. So if we go up, yes, so that's like the maximum. We go up by 33. It's actually not too bad of a gradient, I must admit. It's not that bad. Okay. And this, let's see. If we push this forward and straight. Out by another 6 units, let's see. Now I'm just purely speculating and experimenting here, guys, so forgive me. Okay, so what would this give us? We might have to jump into the overlap tool. That gives us 8 by 11. That's not bad enough. And see if we can connect this. Okay, so we might have to float this like so. But that will work. Okay. I would prefer if we could have another pillar over here. Perhaps we can. Let's have a look. If we were to upgrade. And let's see. Pillars. And upgrade this. Let's see. Will that actually... Let's do it. And where is that pillar? If there is a pillar... Oi, why have you been no? I want you to be a default highway and change you back to this. Not the super stack. Why is that super stacking? Maybe super stacking. I don't want super stack. I want a normal highway. Highway ramp pillar. Let's see if that changes anything. There we go. Actually changed it. That's a ramp. Ramp pillar. They're kind of small. Road. Small bridge. Medium road. Highway. Ramp. Highway bridge. No. Suspension. No. That's just the default. Okay. So any wider though, this would be affecting the actual railway line here. Yeah, that just kind of touches, if we can see, as you, right there, it kind of will have trains kind of touching that, but it's such a small detail, I'm willing to live with it, if you guys are as well. But at least we've got a pillar there, so it actually looks like that there is some sort of support happening over here, which I'm more than happy with. I like to see that there is still some sort of a support system running, so they're just floating in the air. All right, so that doesn't look too bad. Okay, so we will have to make extra connections to come off this, and perhaps even avenues joining up, so we might have to get some creativity going. Definitely, we'll have to get some creativity going. Now, I'm also considering how can we possibly, if we just run this perhaps over the top, we might be able to connect. So let's see. Let's just jump into collide and push this forward. this avenue at least anyway. Like so. Now, this is going to be a bit of a tricky situation here for me. So I just want to see if I can do this as best as possible. I'm currently considering whether or not we should change the direction of this over here as well. And I think I'd like to do that. So let's just try and do that. If I push this down in this direction, like so, okay, this will give me the availability to change direction with this avenue that's coming through over here. So let's just remove that. Let's rejoin this highway together. Okay, and that creates a pillar here, which I don't want. So let's just remove that for now temporarily. Okay, so let's get this in. Let's see, from here to here, that should work. Okay, so we'll jump in as close as possible to the highway, I think. Let's see, what do we have over here? Remove that. Let's just jump into around, say, over here. That can come out to here. And let's see the connection. This out to there. No. This out to here. Perfect. Okay, I'm happy with that. Let's remove this. And that way we can have this look a little bit more natural. You might have to bend this avenue across as well a little bit in the near future. Let's reconnect this highway now. There we go. Done. Okay. Good. Next challenging part, I think. A very challenging part is... let's build this avenue in this direction. That way we can get a guide over here. We can get extra boxes that are guides. Okay. And what I'd like to do is actually now lift this up to 12 using the super stack. Thank you very much. Automatically does jumps up to super stack. I like that. We're going to have to jump into overlap though for this area. Okay, so can we push it back one? I think I had it right there. Okay, I'm happy with that. Okay, I'm gonna have to push this out to say around over here in the same way. And now, ooh, we have to increase the height as well. Don't forget that. So let's remove that section that we just built. That can stay, I guess. So let's see, 12 units, that's 11, so let's just remove that. Can we just place it up like this? No, is the answer. Can we? Ooh, no. So if I were to place that out to say here, there we go, go up by 12. That's not enough, that's only... So I've got to make it a lot shorter. So from here, for example, let's chuck it up by... That's 15. So after this, I'm going to go out by another 3 units. Okay, so that's a good reference point. So if we can get it, that is, to snap into position where we want it. So I'm going to presume that's 1, 2, 1, 2, and 3. Out to here, and now... Let's come back. That's 13 units, but that should be not fine. That creates an extra pillar in the middle, which I don't want. So we'll just have to do it. No, I'm not satisfied with that. Sorry, guys. You guys are probably pulling your hair out. This is really frustrating for me. Don't worry, but I want things to be good. Okay, so there we go. 12 by 24, and it reaches the straight part. The end of the straight part that we've got operating over here. Remove that. Okay, so no, we need to go jump down to 12. Actually, there is an easier way to do this now that I consider it. We can just chuck that up to 24 around over here. If we can get it to snap, there we go. Make another little 24 segment. From this area, we can just jump down. Why didn't I think of this earlier? Come on. Okay, there we go. And now just chuck that down. Something like that. We can remove this segment now. And we can just simply curve this. Hey, we have a problem here. We've got a pillar actually showing up in the wrong place. So I might have to do this freehand. Not an issue though, is it? Ooh, it may be an issue. This actually may provide us with an issue. So what we might do is just float this. Even without snapping? Can we do this without snapping? No, it wants to snap. That's annoying. Okay, so I'm going to just do this in the floating mode then. It'll be so much easier from here. Let's see, snapping on. There we go. And now we need to have the pillars super stack on. Let's just upgrade that segment. Oh no, we need the super stack on over here, like so. Why is that super stack, please? There we go. That's better. Super stack. Okay. Now, super stack and super stack. There we go. Well, that's not too bad, actually. Not too bad at all. So we can potentially connect the highway up to the elevated avenue that's running across over here. Now, I don't particularly think that looks very good. And so let me know, guys, what do you think, if that looks good or if we should just connect the highway to the bottom avenue and scrap this idea and just make... Or actually, here we go. I've got another idea. I think I've got a better idea. I really do think I've got a better idea because... All right. Sorry, guys. Sorry, but that's just not going to happen. So I'm going to do this. What I need to do now is I'm going to drag and copy this over. And this is actually going to, let's see, come across out to here. There we go. And from this, actually no. Let's see if we can push this all the way as close as possible. Even there, on the actual intersection will be fine. We can now push this down. 12 units. Might need a guide around over here. So pillars and collide and overlap. No, collide. Alright, so zone that up. Let's get our avenue in. Okay, this needs to be into overlap mode. 12 distance in units. Let's just upgrade this, and this actually needs to be changed to a super stack. Super stack, okay, so now from the super stack we can just jump into our default and we can continue our road with collisions on as per usual. Alright, and now this is where we might get a little bit more sophisticated with our connections. Let's see. Let's push this out a little bit further. Let's see, what do we have? 9 by 8. 9 by 8. Okay, so let's just remove that. Build that out to here. What do we have? It actually doesn't show this to us. So let's remove the highway. Maybe the highway is getting in the way. Highway must be getting in the way. 13 by 12. I want it much shorter than that. So let's just jump out another 4 or 5 units. Now let's see. 14 by 7, that's better. So what we need to do is increase this by 7. And right now we'll just join it up like that. And now the highways will have to be joined up. And that's not what I want here. I want the default. Now this elevated network pillars is still not the greatest. I mean, it's just a brand new mod, I assume. So there's still lots of iron things that need to be ironed out. But so far we got stuff that we wanted out of it. So I'm pretty happy about that. So let's just remove these highways that are not actually right. And just connect them up like this. Okay, so now the actual pillars are underneath proper, not the silly railroad ones. Okay. So I'm very happy with that. Let's see now what we can do. Let's see if we actually can get some expansion. I was going to do some work on not only developing on our industrial area, sorry, our office spaces around over here, but also start developing on our next neighborhood over here. I already have a name for it, so no need to suggest names, guys. I've already got one lined up. It's a neighborhood from Sant'Arcangelo, so that's a little bit of a hint if you guys want to have a guessing game. And while we wait to see how things develop, first of all, let's see how, what would happen if we were, or before we do, I wanted to start adding some in office space around over here. So let's see what we can do. If we just, we need to add these avenues to fix these roads up around over here so that there's no overlapping going on over the top of these roads. And that's not going to work around over here. So we might actually have to just draw a road that should fix the issue around over here. Okay, so now let's remove that zoning. No problems. Okay, excellent. Okay. This area still needs to be fixed up. Avenues. Let's select the avenue. Upgrade with the normal tools that we have. There we go. All fixed up here. This area still also needs to be done as well. There we go. Done. Excellent. So now let's just see if we can add some more office spaces. I don't think we're going to be requiring... Can you please get off my keyboard, kitty? Okay, so now let's just add some more office spaces around over here. Now, this avenue is a bit awkward like that with that kind of a bend. So I'm actually going to continue this through and join it up like so. And now let's see. I'm going to zone this whole internal area right here with office space. And let's see how this develops. I'm hoping that we've got enough demand. I mean, after all, we did demolish quite a bit. But I'm hoping that we've got enough demand so that we don't actually have to establish a neighborhood. Because if we do, then we'll have to save that for next episode. So we're wrapping up right here now, guys. And there we go. We've got some buildings and some avenues which are running right here next to this elevated highway, or not a highway, but elevated road. But they're actually connected to the avenues underneath. So that's a pretty cool little touch. And I'm gonna have to find a way to join up some avenues up to this road, elevated road. And I'm thinking that we're going to be working on this in a way where these roads are going to be that are connecting to the elevated one will be in a T intersection, just to minimize the amount of traffic that's actually coming and meeting this road. So it's a completely different idea. We've got two avenues running over the top of each other, but we'll see how things turn out. I don't think it will look the worst, and hopefully it can manage traffic rather well. So, because the idea is, if we were to connect this bridge avenue up a little bit sooner, say somewhere around roughly around over here, then yeah, it connects to this avenue which is running on the ground, but then cars that want to get to this avenue would have to go through the entire CBD. And so what we're kind of trying to do is create like a bit of a quick bypass out of the downtown area, because knowing myself, especially today after work, trying to get out of the city and the downtown area, it took me so long that I was just wishing I had a bypass area. I just wanted everyone to get out of my way. Unfortunately, that didn't happen. So I've kind of decided that this is something that I want to include in this city, so that option will be available. So for the citizens, if they want to get to, say, these neighborhoods around over here or this industrial area. So let's see, this area has developed rather nicely and we still have demand. This is good. This area will eventually upgrade as well. Just a matter of time, especially once we start adding more services. Let's see. Add another avenue around over here. Just upgrade them, sorry. And let's see. If we add another avenue here, we can add another avenue around over here. So we're kind of joining up avenues around over here. It's not going to be too bad, I don't think. This out to here, this out to here, like so. Now let's see, what do we have? 2x6. So if we go out by another 4 units, we should be able to create a simple 2x2 connection like that. Perfect. So that can connect nicely, and it does connect nicely. Now let's see around over here. Let's see if we can... That's as close as we can potentially get this. This is something that we may have to reconsider, because if I'm to create ramps around over here, I'm going to need some space. And by space, we will require at least a single unit or a single block to be available to us. So if we just join that up over here like that, this area can stay a bit awkward with those connections, but it's this area that needs to connect properly. So if we just remove that and push this through over here, let's see if we can connect this up nicely. Like so, that's actually rather awkward. Let's remove that and join this up, say, over here to here. Like that. Okay, I'm happy with that. Now we will see if we can get some access now using this ramp. So hopefully it won't take long. But hopefully it does start happening, unless there are faster ways, more efficient ways to get here, which I assume for the time being there might be using these highways. Although we don't have still yet proper highway connectivity going on around over here. So that's another thing that we're going to have to work on. And just like we did in Santa Cangelo, I've got the idea that we might actually make a connection coming out of the downtown area. So say somewhere around to here. So do we have like a central piece? We do have a central kind of location around over here like that. So perhaps I can create like a temporary guide so that you guys can see. If we just create something like that, there's going to be our main like kind of area that's going to be entering into our downtown area via another highway. There we go. So that's planned. There you go. Can we add a park around over here before we finish up? Let's see, the park that I want is the park that I made, and we can on either side, which is nice. Just considering, yeah, I'll put the park on either side, just like that. There we go. And that's actually the wrong park. We need the other park, the one with concrete. Like so. There we go. Perfect. And we'll be able to make all the necessary connections, I think, later on anyway. Or we can even place it kind of in the middle so that we can connect these pathways to the actual pedestrian crossings around over here. So that's the idea. So something like that. Although we still may reconsider. We'll see what happens. That's in the future. So we might add a little bit of a lake here, though we're going to have to be mindful of this highway access point. So, and that's probably going to have to go down another level so that it goes underneath the other highway around over here. And then I'm going to have to consider where I want this actual highway to connect to. So it will probably be to a point somewhere around over here. So we'll probably make a T-intersection somewhere around over here where our laked up neighborhoods will be. So this lake may actually have to change. So it's good that we haven't started working around over here yet. Something that I'm still going to have to fix is the water around over here. I know, thanks for the suggestions, guys, by the way, of actually having have like underwater rivers flowing through here that which are deeper. So that's actually something that I'm going to be doing as well. So let's see before we finish up how this area is looking. This is all nice and good. I think everything is connected. The railway lines are still working, are they not? I don't see any railway lines or any trains operating here, do we? Let's see. Yes, we do still have our train lines here, but I don't see any trains. Now, I'm hoping that we haven't actually broken the game by doing these bridges over the top of avenues. And there we go, we do have actual work, these avenues actually working here, one on top of the other. So that's working, so the railway lines should technically work, I believe. And yes, we do have an external line coming, so that's good. So our external line is working, it just delivered some passengers. And let's just wait for our internal line. Yes, we do have an internal line train coming in, and it's absolutely full, so it won't take enough passengers on board, and it will continue to run. So that suggestion to actually make this into a loop just may actually have to happen, because I believe that these stations will not be able to manage with these numbers, especially with the amount of trains that we've got operating. So the last stop around over here at our industrial area right here will definitely have to be changed. Well, not changed, but we'll have to continue the line through, and we'll see how we do that. And the line will actually have to connect up with the line which ends at Riverside over here. So that's something to look forward to as well. So thank you for that suggestion. Now that I've kind of examined the way our rail network is working, it's definitely something that we're going to have to work on and do. See, there we go. The train only took like half the passengers. So we can definitely make our rail network a lot more efficient so that we can get a lot more or better financial benefits out of our train network. Well, these trains stack up relatively quickly one after the other. It's not too bad. So, yeah. We will work on that. We'll have two separate lines, so that way we'll have extra trains, train services, and there'll be just better rotation. So we shouldn't have overcrowding and overloading on specific train stations. Something to look forward to is also adding some bus lines around into our industrial area around over here. So that's something we have to still work on. And also, of course, into our neighborhoods around over here. So that's something that we need to look at. So still much more and plenty more progress to be done and had. And I think this has actually turned out a lot better, especially this area where we've actually made this avenue jump underneath the avenue, sorry, underneath the highway. And we'll connect these highways up at a different location. So yeah, I think it's turning out rather good. A little bit of, I guess, pre-planning work has been developed before we actually continue properly working on the next episode. But nonetheless, it's been done, so you guys can actually see a little bit of developmental work that I usually do between episodes. So yeah, I would have had all these roads done normally, and then what we would have been doing is pretty much just focusing on the zoning aspects. But now we've done a bit of both, and we can see that it's all working out. We've taken a few things into consideration and know what's working and what's not. So yeah, that's about it, guys. So for now, thanks for giving me some really, really good advice and tips and just ideas of what we can do for future episodes and how to develop the city. And yeah, please subscribe if you're new, because we'll have many more videos coming out. Also, don't forget to have a look at the Twitch site. I've got lots of work or in between work peering up on that. The new job is actually going very, very well, so thank you for all the best wishes and all that, guys. So I really appreciate it. I'm very happy, and I really, really like the job that I'm doing, so I'm kind of focused on that at the moment. But don't worry, I won't leave you guys hanging just like that. I do want to keep this city and series going, because I actually really do love this. And don't forget to like the Facebook page. I'm actually just going to jump on right now, and post up an update that I have recorded episode 12, and we'll be uploading it in the near future. So it's little updates like that that I will be providing. If you like the Facebook page, you will get those notifications and will be aware of when next contents will be available. So for now, guys, take care. I'll see you all very, very soon. Bye bye for now.